Greetings. This video is to teach my Muslim brothers and sisters in general about the blood sacrifices which Almighty God has required. It is prompted by the following comment from a follower of Islam. How can a Muslim convert into a false religion called Christianity knowing the following differences? 1. False Christian's God needs shedding blood of an innocent righteous man or his own death under torture to forgive sins of other sinners. Muslims, Allah is merciful and forgives a sinner through his sincere repentance. This is part of a grocery list of incorrect Islamic information. I'll address number 1 in this video. The topic of sacrifice is an important part of the message of the prophets, brother. This is actually a staggering difference between the God of Jews and Christians and the Allah of Muhammad's religion. First, we must understand from the beginning, blood sacrifice was needed. Genesis 4:3, and in process of time it came to pass that Cain brought of the fruit of the ground an offering unto the Lord. And Abel, he also brought of the firstlings of his flock, and of the fat thereof. And the Lord had respect unto Abel and to his offering, but unto Cain and his offering he had not respect. And Cain was very wroth, and his countenance fell. For some reason God respected the sacrifice of a lamb, but not the offering of grain. Genesis 4:9, and the Lord said unto Cain, Where is Abel thy brother? And he said, I don't know. Am I my brother's keeper? And he, the Lord, said, What hast thou done? The voice of thy brother's blood crieth unto me from the ground. God said, Abel's blood cried out from the ground. There is something unique about blood, which the prophets reveal. Does God honor a sacrifice of blood more than that of a plant? Leviticus 17:11, For the life of the flesh is in the blood, and I have given it to you upon the altar to make an atonement for your souls. For it is the blood that makes an atonement for the soul. God has given the blood to make atonement. This is what Prophet Moses revealed in the Torah. Plants do not have blood. Since plants do not have blood, they cannot make atonement for sin. This is just what Prophet Moses revealed in the Torah. Now, if you call yourself Muslim, aren't you supposed to respect the Torah? Aren't you supposed to respect Prophet Moses? Hebrews 9:22, And almost all things are by the law purged with blood, and without shedding of blood is no remission. This is what the Word of God tells us. The message of the prophets is in total agreement with the New Testament. Now, the original Muslim post attacks the very message of the prophets. False Christians' God needs shedding blood of an innocent righteous man or his own death under torture to forgive sins of other sinners. Muslims, Allah is merciful and forgives a sinner through his sincere repentance. How is it, my Muslim friend, this poster is completely ignorant of what Moses said? Not only that, but the Muslim mocks the God of Moses. The sacrifice of blood required by the Lord is completely established by Prophet Moses. Leviticus 16:3, Aaron shall enter the holy place with this, with a bull for a sin offering, and a ram for a burnt offering. In verse 11, Then Aaron shall offer the bull of the sin offering, which is for himself, and make atonement for himself and for his household. And he shall slaughter the bull of the sin offering, which is for himself. When the bull is slaughtered, its blood will be spilled. This formal practice began with Moses' own brother Aaron. And strangely, Muhammad's religion knows nothing of the true practices of the religion God established with Prophet Moses. The sacrifice of Messiah is further revealed in the prophets of Almighty God. Isaiah 53:5, "But he was pierced for our transgressions, he was crushed for our iniquities. Upon him was the chastisement that brought us peace, and with his wounds we are healed." The "he" in this statement refers to the Messiah. This is Prophet Isaiah revealing God's message, not a follower of Paul hundreds of years later. Prophet Isaiah also foretold the virgin birth of the Messiah. Not only that, but Prophet Zechariah repeats mention of "he who was pierced." Zechariah 12:10, "I will pour out on the house of David and on the inhabitants of Jerusalem the spirit of grace and of supplication, so that they will look on me whom they have pierced, and they will mourn for him as one mourns for an only son, and they will weep bitterly over him like the bitter weeping over a firstborn." In this context, Prophet Zechariah is speaking Yahweh's words. Prophet Isaiah mentions Messiah will be pierced and sacrificed. Prophet Zechariah reveals the one who was pierced is Yahweh. The message of the prophets hints and implies that Messiah is Yahweh. The sacrifice of Messiah is further revealed by the prophets of Almighty God. Isaiah 53:7, "He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. Like a lamb that is led to the slaughter, and like a sheep that is before its shearers is silent, so he opened not his mouth." This was fulfilled by the Christ, the Messiah, Jesus. Matthew 27:12, "And when he was accused by the chief priests and elders, he gave no answer." Matthew 27:14, "But Jesus gave no answer, not even to a single charge, much to the governor's amazement." Isaiah 53:8, "By oppression and judgment he was taken away. And as for his generation, who considered that he was cut off out of the land of the living, stricken for the transgression of my people?" Cut off from the land of the living means Messiah would be killed. There is not any reasonable way to avoid that interpretation. And if Prophet Isaiah is not clear enough for you, God sent Prophet Daniel to repeat the message. Daniel 9:26, "And after 62 weeks shall Messiah be cut off, but not for himself." Two prophets reveal Messiah would be killed. Why? Messiah shall be cut off by Daniel 9:26, but not for himself. In Isaiah 53:8 it answers that he was cut off out of the land of the living, stricken for the transgression of my people. Please try to think, dear Muslim. Why believe comments by those who contradict the message of the prophets? False Christians' God needs shedding of an innocent righteous man or his own death under torture to forgive sins of other sinners. Fools ignore the message of the prophets, and they follow Satan to his hell doing so. The sacrifice of blood is well established by the message of the prophets. The sacrifice of Messiah is also well established in the message of the prophets. Messiah will die, like a lamb, as a sacrifice for the sins of all people. O Muslim, are you not taught to think Prophet John or Yahya is a prophet? John 1:29, "The next day John saw Jesus coming toward him and said, 'Look, the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world.'" Oh, Muslim, listen to the words of Prophet John. Hear and regard the message of the prophets. Prophet John was foretold by two other prophets. Isaiah 40, verse 3, "The voice of him that crieth in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway for our God." Prophet Isaiah revealed one who would announce the Lord in the earth. Malachi 3, 1, "Behold, I send my messenger, and he will prepare the way before me." God says he will send a messenger or prophet to prepare the way for God. Prophet Isaiah also said a voice would come preparing the way for God. Prophet John said that he was the voice. John 1:23, John replied in the words of Isaiah the prophet, "I am a voice of one calling in the wilderness, make straight the way for the Lord." Prophet John was the voice who would prepare, make straight the way for God in the earth. Now, I think one of the biggest points of confusion for Muslims is that Jesus was a prophet. How could Jesus be a prophet and be God, or the Son of God? We need to finish reading Malachi 3:1. We've read this. "Behold, I will send my messenger, and he will prepare the way." We have already seen this was Prophet John, the voice Prophet Isaiah foretold. "Behold, I will send my messenger." Notice that this is God speaking, and he will send Prophet John. Pay attention who God will send Prophet John to come before. Before me. God said, "I will send Prophet John to come before me." Allow that to really sink in, brother. God said, "I will send Prophet John to come before me." This is the message of Prophet Malachi about Prophet John. And Prophet Malachi is not through yet. "And the Lord whom you seek shall suddenly come to his temple, even the messenger of the covenant." The Lord will come to his temple. How will he come? The Lord will come to his temple as a messenger of the covenant. Even the messenger of the covenant. As a prophet sent by God. So, dear Muslim, when you say Jesus was a prophet, I must agree. Because Prophet Malachi said God would come to his temple as a prophet. Please think about just how many prophets all give God's message, my Muslim brother. Prophet Moses, Prophet Isaiah, Prophet Daniel, Prophet Zechariah, Prophet David with the Psalms, Prophet Malachi, and then Prophet John. And then God came as Prophet Jesus, fulfilling the words of Prophet Malachi. I have mostly focused on only the Old Testament prophets. However, the New Testament is full of the knowledge of the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of truth, the Comforter Jesus promised. The Comforter has guided us into all this truth, just as Jesus promised. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.